Use time wisely. Make the best use of the time because the days are evil. Time is so precious. You can't earn more of it or reuse it. Once it's spent, it's gone forever. Where we spend our time is where we place our value. As you begin to examine your life today, may God give you eyes to see what's hindering you and what truly brings you life. How we spend our time is the foundation to our success. So, use time wisely. God bless. In the sixth chapter, we have been seeing the various factors of production and how the factors of production have to be rewarded according to their marginal productivity. Today, let us see about rent. What is rent? Rent is the price or the reward given for the use of land or house or a machine to the owner. So, rent is given to the owner. Rent can be given for the usage of land, or if you are using a house or a machine, you have to give some amount as rent to the owner. You will be living in houses which is owned by someone else. He is called the owner. Your house might be owned by a person. So, you are occupying his house for a month or for a year or for many years. So, you get into an agreement with the owner saying that you will pay 1000 rupees or 2000 rupees or 3000 rupees for using his property or for using his land or using his house. So, that is only called as a rent in economics. But in economics, rent or economic rent refers to that part of payment made by a tenant to his landlords for the use of land only. In economics, rent is given only for using the land. It is not for using the machine or for using the house. In economics, rent, or it can also be called as economic rent, refers to that part of payment made by a tenant. Who is a tenant? Owner is different and tenant is different. The person who owns the land is called as the owner. The person who is using the land of someone else is called as the tenant. So here, the tenant has to pay an amount to the landlord or to the owner for using the land. So, in economics, rent or economic rent refers to that part of payment made by a tenant to his landlords for the use of land only. Now, let us study Ricardian theory of rent. Ricardian theory of rent was given by David Ricardo. This is the picture of David Ricardo. So, David Ricardo has given a theory for rent which is called as the Ricardian theory of rent. So, what does David Ricardo say about rent? Rent is that portion of the produce of the earth which is paid to the landlord for the use of the original and indestructible powers of the soil. So, rent is that portion of the produce of the earth which is paid to the landlord for the use of the original and indestructible powers of the soil. The earth, the land or the soil has got original power, has got indestructible power. What do you mean by original? It was not created by anyone. The landlord did not do anything to the fertility of the soil. It is original. It is the gift of nature or it is the gift of God. Land, earth, soil is a gift of God. It has got certain original and at the same time indestructible powers. You cannot destroy the power of the soil. Maybe you can destroy a glass tumbler, or you can destroy your notebook, or you can destroy a cupboard, or you can destroy a cup or something. But can we ever destroy the soil or the land? No, that is only called as indestructible powers. So, according to David Ricardo, rent is the portion of the produce of the earth. Suppose if a farmer is cultivating the land and if he gets 100 bags of paddy, he cannot use all the 100 bags of paddy for himself. A part of it, maybe 20 bags or 30 bags, should be paid to the landlord. Okay, out of the 100 bags, 20 bags or 30 bags has to be paid to the landlord. Why should he pay to the landlord? Because the land belongs to the landlord and he is just the tenant. So for using the land of the landlord and for using the original and indestructible powers of the soil, the tenant has to give a portion of the produce of the earth to the landlord, which is called as a rent. Hope you understood it. So rent is that portion of the produce of the earth which is paid to the landlord for the use of the original and indestructible powers of the soil. This definition for rent is given by David Ricardo. Suppose if they ask you to give the meaning of rent, you can write these lines. If they ask you to define rent, then you have to give the definition given by David Ricardo. So what is Ricardian theory of rent? The classical theory of rent is called the Ricardian theory of rent. So the classical theory of rent is only called as the Ricardian theory of rent. David Ricardo only has given the theory of rent. So this is the definition given by David Ricardo. If this question is asked as a 5-mark question, you can start from here. You can start writing the definition, then you can write the assumptions. So what are the assumptions? These are the assumptions. There are 9 assumptions for Ricardian theory of rent. First one, land differs in fertility. You know that all lands are not of equal fertility. It differs. In some places, the land will be very fertile. If you take the Gangetic Plains or the Kaveri Belt, the land will be very fertile. Whereas if you take some other, the desert area, the land will not be very fertile. So land differs in fertility. Even in our school, if you see in certain places, if you put a seed or if you keep a sapling, it will grow. Whereas in some places, it will not grow because the land differs in fertility. The law of diminishing returns operates in agriculture. What do you mean by law of diminishing returns? What happens after using a land continuously? If you start using more and more of the land, or if you start using more and more of labor, you will not get increasing returns. From 100 bags of rice, it may come to 80 bags, it may come to 60 bags. It will not increase. After a particular point, the law of diminishing returns will operate. Next, rent depends upon the fertility and location of the land. Rent depends upon the fertility. A land which is more fertile will get more rent. Location also is very important. For simple example, for you to understand this, if you go out looking for houses to rent, the broker will say, near Porsavakam area, near Teelpok area, Annanagar area, the rent is more. Whereas if you go to some other remote places like Tirthani or Gumadipundi or away from the Chennai city, they will say the rent will be less. Why? The location matters. Because if you are in the city, you have the post office, you have the bank, you have schools, you have hospitals, you have good facilities, you have gym, you have malls inside the city. So the land or the house which is located within a city or in a specific area like Annanagar and Porsavakam, where it is very commercial, the rent of the land or the rent of the house will be more. So likewise, fertility, depending on the fertility, rent depends upon the fertility and location of the land. Theory assumes perfect competition. You know what is perfect competition? Homogeneous product, perfect mobility of factors, all these are under perfect competition. So this theory assumes perfect competition. It is based on the assumption of long period. This is for a long period and not for the short period. And there is existence of marginal land or no rent land. What do you mean by marginal land? Sometimes what happens, the cost of the production will be equal to the price of the produce. So you do not get much from these lands. That is why it is called as rent of the rent. For example, you are spending 100 rupees to cultivate something. Okay, to cultivate brinjal or something, you are spending 100 rupees. When you sell the brinjal, you are getting only 100 rupees. So the cost of production is equal to the price of the produce. Such lands are called as marginal lands or no rent land. Next, land has got certain original and indestructible powers. We have already seen this. Land is used for cultivation only. Here in Ricardian theory, he says it is used only for cultivation. Whereas it is not like that in reality. We can use land to build a complex, to build a mall, to have a swimming pool, to have a gymnasium, to have a school or a hospital. Land has got multipurpose. You can use the land for anything. You can construct an apartment or an individual house or a school or a market or a mall. So land can be used for many purposes, but Ricardo says land is used only for cultivation here. The last thing is most fertile lands are cultivated first. He says the land which is the most fertile is cultivated first, but it doesn't happen like that. You buy a land and you start cultivating, only then you will know whether it is fertile or not. But here he assumes that the most fertile lands are cultivated first. So these are the assumptions of the Ricardian theory of rent. So Ricardo explains his theory with an example. I will also give you a practical example so that you will be able to understand it better. Just imagine yourself getting admitted into a school. Last year in 11th standard you were admitted, but unfortunately we were not able to meet in the school. Imagine a situation where you are admitted in standard 11. Okay. You are the first person to enter the class. I will be seated there. Just imagine that situation. I am seated there in the classroom and you are entering the class. First we exchange some pleasantries. I ask, well, how are you? What is your name? Everything. Then later on I say, okay, you go and sit down. What will you do? There are 40 chairs. Okay. So you are the first person to come there. So what will you do? You will look around and you will see which is the most comfortable place. You will try to sit just under the fan, or you will try to sit in front of the blackboard so that you will have a clear vision of the blackboard, or you will try to sit near the window. You will have many places to select because you are the first person. Okay. After some time, another 5 girls come. What do? They will also try to select the best places. Likewise, out of the 40, 30 girls have come now, then 35, 36, 37, 38. 39, and the last girl is coming. The last girl has no other option other than to sit in the place which is vacant. She cannot come and say, I will sit under the fan, because already someone else will be sitting there. She cannot sit near the blackboard, because already that place is occupied. She cannot sit near the window because that place is occupied. So she will just search and she will find the vacant place and she can sit only there, because she was the last person to come. Hope you understood this. Likewise, Ricardo has given an example for his theory. Now, I think if I explain this, you will be able to understand it better. Assume that some people go to a newly discovered island and settle down there. Group of people are going to an island and they are going to settle down there. And there are 3 grades of land, namely land A, grade B land and grade C land. A being the most fertile, B less fertile, and C the least fertile land. So there are 3 grades of land. A is the best, B next, and C is the least fertile. They will first cultivate all the most fertile land, that is the A grade land. People who came first will select the A grade land because that is the most fertile. Since the land is abundant, they are the first one to come to the land. So the land is abundant and it is also idle. And so there is no need to pay rent as long as such best lands are freely available. So the people who came first to through the island need not pay rent to anybody because the land is available in plenty and it is free. So they can use it freely. So here they are starting to cultivate that A grade land. What happens for 1 acre? They are able to get 40 bags of paddy. A grade land cultivate பண்றாங்க, அதுதான் most fertile. அதுல இருந்து உங்களுக்கு எத்தனை bags of paddy கிடைக்குது? 40 bags of paddy கிடைக்குது. Okay? So they are going to the A grade land. A grade is the first best land, most fertile land, and they have started cultivating here, and they are able to cultivate 40 bags of rice. Okay? This is the graph. X-axis, you have plotted the various grades of land, A grade, B grade and C grade. And here you have yield per acre. So the first acre gives 40 bags of rice. Now, you just imagine another group of people are coming to the island. The second batch of people are coming here. Here, the demand is more. Already, a group of people have already occupied the land. Now, some more people are coming and they need food. So there is a demand. What happens? Hence the demand for agricultural produce will increase. So the most fertile lands alone cannot produce all the food grades which is needed for the entire group of people, because the population has increased and this, at the same time there is operation of the law of diminishing returns. So the less fertile land, that is the B grade land, will have to be brought under cultivation in order to meet the growing needs of the growing population. So for the same amount of labor and capital employed in the A grade, the same amount is used even in the B grade land, but now they are able to get only 30 bags of rice. Inga use panna adhe labor, adhe technology, ellathay use pandranga, labor, capital, technology, inga 40 bags vandhudhu, adhe idu B la use pannumbodhu avangalukku evlo dhaan varudhu, 30 dhaan varudhu. அப்போ இந்த 30க்கும் 40க்கும் உள்ள டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் எவ்வளவு? 10. ஃபர்ஸ்ட் போனவங்க வந்து 40 பேக்ஸ் ஆஃப் பாடி தே வர் ஏபிள் டு கல்டிவேட். செகண்ட் கிரேட் லேண்ட் தே காட் 30. ஸோ 40 மைனஸ் 30 வில் கிவ் 10. ஸோ திஸ் 10 இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் தி எக்கனாமிக் ரெண்ட். இந்த 10க்கு பேர் என்னது? எக்கனாமிக் ரெண்ட். வெர் யூ ஏபிள் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் த டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் பிட்வீன் கிரேட் ஏ அண்ட் கிரேட் பி லேண்ட் இஸ் 10. Here they made 40 bags of rice, here 30 bags of rice, so difference is 10. This 10 is called as the economic rent. Suppose yet another group of people go and settle down in the same island. So the least fertile land, that is the C grade land, will be brought under cultivation. So now the same amount of labor and capital for per acre is able to give only 20 bags of rice. Here it gave 40, here it gave 30, here it gave only 20 bags of rice. This surplus of A grade land is now raised to 20 bags. So what happens? First, A grade land fetched 40 bags. Here it is able to fetch only 20. So the difference between 40 and 20 is 20. So this is called as the economic rent now. When compared to C, 20 is the economic rent for A. When compared to C, 10 is the economic rent for grade B land. Purinjadama, B a compare panamudhu, A ke economic rent 10 dhaan kadachadhu. C a compare panamudhu, A ke economic rent 20 kadaikadhu, B ke economic rent evlo dhaan kadaikadhu, 10 dhaan kadaikadhu. Appo idu ellaa innadhu economic rent. A ke vandhu 20 when compared to C grade land, B ke 10 when compared to C. So the surplus of A grade land is now raised to 20 bags. Now A gets 20 bags. Initially it was getting only 10 bags of paddy. Now when compared to C, it has got 20 bags. And that is called as the economic rent of A. This is called as economic rent of A. This is called as economic rent of B. So A gets 20 as economic rent. B gets 10 as economic rent. So this is the economic rent of B and this is the economic rent of A. Whereas there is no economic rent for grade C. So this illustration, I think you will be able to understand now. So in the above illustration, C grade land, cost of production is just equal to the price of its produced and therefore does not yield any rent. The cost of production is 20 bags. The yield also is 20 bucks. So there is no rent for grade C land. So grade C land is called as no rent land, or it is also called as marginal land. In the grade C ku peru enadhu no rent land nu sollalam, marginal land nu sollalam. Therefore, no rent land or marginal land is the land in which the cost of production is just equal to the price of its produce. The land which yields rent is called intra-marginal land. In the land la rent varudho andha land ku peru intra-marginal land. அப்ப ஏயும் பிக்கும் பேர் என்னது இன்ட்ரா மார்ஜினல் லேண்ட். சிக்கு பேரு நோ ரெண்ட் லேண்ட். சோ தேர்ஃபோர் ரெண்ட் இண்டிகேட்ஸ் த டிஃபரன்ஷியல் அட்வான்டேஜ் ஆஃப் த சுப்பீரியர் லேண்ட் ஓவர் மார்ஜினல் லேண்ட். சோ ஃப்ரம் திஸ் யூ கேன் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் த ஃபர்டிலிட்டி ஆஃப் த லேண்ட் டிஃபர்ஸ். சோ த லேண்ட் விச் இஸ் மோர் ஃபர்டைல் இஸ் மோர் அட்வான்டேஜஸ். இதே தான் இங்கே கொடுத்துருக்காங்க. கிரேட்ஸ் ஆஃப் லேண்ட் ஏ பி அண்ட் சி. ப்ரொடக்ஷன் இன் பேக்ஸ், பேடி பேக்ஸ். ஏ கெட்ஸ் 40 பேக்ஸ், 30 பேக்ஸ் அண்ட் 20 பேக்ஸ். சர்ப்ளஸ் ரெண்ட் ஆர் தி எக்கனாமிக் ரெண்ட் ஆஃப் ஏ இஸ் லீஸ்டாக வந்தது எவ்வளவு 20. 40 மைனஸ் 20 இஸ் 20. ஸோ த எக்கனாமிக் ரெண்ட் ஃபார் ஏ இஸ் 20 பேக்ஸ். த எக்கனாமிக் ரெண்ட் ஃபார் பி இஸ் 10 பேக்ஸ். அண்ட் தெர் இஸ் நோ சர்ப்ளஸ் ஆர் தெர் இஸ் நோ ரெண்ட் ஃபார் லேண்ட் சி. ஸோ யூ ஹாவ் டு எக்ஸ்பிளைன் திஸ் கிராஃப். In the diagram, x-axis represents the various grades of land and y-axis represents yield per acre in bags. OA, AB and BC are, this is land A, grade A, this is grade B and this is grade C. Okay, OA is called as grade A. OA is grade A. AB is grade B and this is called C grade land. BC is called as C grade land. The application of equal amount of labor and capital on each of them gives a yield represented by the rectangle standing just above the respective bases. So this is the yield per acre. The C grade land is the no rent land. This is called as no rent land. Whereas A and B are called as intra-marginal lands. The economic rent yielded by A and B grade land is equal to the shaded area of the respective rectangles. Hope you understood this. So here you have criticisms. So what are the criticisms? The order of cultivation from most fertile to least fertile land is historically wrong. You cannot say that only the fertile lands are cultivated first and then only the least fertile lands. It is, there is nothing proved like that. Historically, it is wrong. Second one, this theory assumes that rent does not enter into price, but in reality, rent enters price. So they say that if you calculate the rent and then give the price of the product, it will be more. So the rent does not enter the price. Rent you say thona price jaasti aayirum. அதனால் ரிகார்டோ என்ன சொல்றாரு, ரெண்ட் டஸ் நாட் என்டர் இன் டு பிரைஸ் பட் இன் ரியாலிட்டி ரெண்ட் என்டர்ஸ் பிரைஸ். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் அபவுட் த ரிகார்டியன் தியரி ஆஃப் ரெண்ட். எக்கனாமிக்ஸ் இஸ் வெரி வெரி இன்ட்ரெஸ்டிங் கேர்ள்ஸ். இஃப் யூ ஆர் ஏபிள் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஆல் திஸ் ஹேப்பன்ஸ் இன் ரியாலிட்டி, ஓகே, பட் வி டு நாட் நோ த பிரின்சிபல்ஸ் ஆஃப் எக்கனாமிக்ஸ் ஆர் யூஸ்ட் இன் எவ்ரி செக்டார். டேக் இட், லெட் இட் பி அக்ரிகல்ச்சரல் செக்டார் ஆர் இண்டஸ்ட்ரியல் செக்டார் ஆர் டெர்ஷியல் செக்டார். Economics is applied everywhere. Economics is a very, very important subject. If you master in economics, your future will be really bright. Okay? Only thing is, children think that economics is very dry, it is very boring. It is not like that. If you're able to understand, you will feel that economics is one of the best subjects. Okay? So, you have an important question, 5-mark question. Illustrate the Ricardian theory of rent. Illustrate the Ricardian theory of rent. If that question is asked, you have to write about the Ricardian theory of rent. You have to write about rent. Ricardian theory of rent. You have to give the definition. Then you have to write the assumption. Then you have to draw the graph, the table. Then you have to give the explanation. Then you have to write about the criticism. Okay? Hope you understood it, girls.